Let's take a meander down memory lane. It's 1970, it's summer, the kids are running around the sprinklers, the Hills hoist is flying, yes. And the backyard Weber is roasting a few snags. And of course, sitting front and centre on the table is the humble cob dip. Fast forward to today, and thousands of people are celebrating the classic cob. There's an entire festival dedicated to its very existence, and Scott Tweedie thought he'd check it out.
I'm here on the Gold Coast for the celebration of a family barbecue favourite. I'm not talking about your jats with the cube cheese or the snag. It is the almighty cob loaf. Believe it or not, there's an entire festival here tonight to celebrate the cob loaf. So I'm going to find out how to master that crusty bread with the creamy filling. And I can feel I'm going to have the time of my loaf. Start the pun counter.
I'm feeling a little crazy.
Michelle, you've created this cob loaf festival. What is it all about, and why the cob loaf?
Well, the cob loaf is quintessentially Australian, and Night Quarter is all about Australian community coming together. We're open every Friday and Saturday night, 4 till 10, and we're all about community.
We've always got one of those aunties or uncles that has a little bit too much cob loaf too. They hog the cob. You know what I'm talking about.
And no double dipping.
No double dipping at all. Uncle Brian, I'm talking to you right now. Do you know they say that loafter is the best medicine?
Loafter.
She's loafing her head off. This man here is a very crust-worthy man. He's one of the judges, the adjudicators for tonight's best cob loaf at the festival. What are you looking for?
Absolutely. We're looking for a good-sized cob to start with. You can't have a good cob loaf without a decent-sized cob. Obviously, you need to have very good filling. It's got to taste good, and ultimately it has to have a good bit of Aussie love with it. You know, I know it was English originally, but the Aussies have perfected the art. So it's got to have that Aussie look, Aussie backyard. Think Benin, think Bond's body shirts, think Holden Taranas. That's exactly what you're looking for, a bit of that 70s love style.
So if it has all that, it will be the true breadwinner.
Absolutely, it's a winner.
Crumb again.
It'll be a winner.
Crumb again.
A big winner.
Crumb again.
Winner, cob winner. It's a winner.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Fellas, what do we have here?
We've got the macaroni and maple bacon cob loaf. We saw him walking around and we're like, we need to go where that is, you know? We need to try this. I've been nibbling on it as I've been walking because it's just so good, you know?
Have you had cob loaf before?
No, I haven't, no.
First time you're doing it in style?
Yeah.
I reckon you're cheating on the good old Bunnings snag, aren't you?
Not quite, not today.
What makes a good cob?
I feel like it has to have the right amount of cheese and just fresh bread, really. Good ingredients.
How many cobs would you say you've had in your lifetime?
Oh, who knows? I love my bread.
Carla, you're making a seafood cob. What's in the seafood cob?
So we've got some scallops, some lovely prawns, and some whiting. In a creamy garlic sauce, in a nice cob loaf with some chips on the side.
You're very busy. How many cobs have you made tonight?
About 150.
I think
I love you.
I think this lady's got one of the sweetest cobs here. Margaret, you got this cob. What is it made of?
Okay, hot donut, heaps of Nutella, big scoop of vanilla ice cream, and it's made with love. Talk about it. And did
not go and shout it when you walk. So you've got your Oreos up the top here, then you've got your delicious marshmallows, but the piece de resistance is in the middle there, and I'm just gonna get rid of those, get in here, and that is what you want when you get into a cob. Unbelievable. Why am I laughing? You think you love me? I think I love you.
This is my thing. It's what I do. It's what I bring to parties.
And I don't know about cob loaf.
I've never heard of it either.
It doesn't
the best
really
thing
go
is,
below the tweed.
Is it a Queensland thing?
I think maybe it is. I've had it all over Australia.
Have you had it?
Yeah. A lot of taverns have it on their entree sections, like garlic cob loaf, and they slice it up or they have you at the
Well, the best thing, you make it, you get it basically a loaf, and then you dig out the middle so it's a bowl, and then you put four times. My specialty is cheesy bacon and onion cob loaf.
Oh,
and then you use the bowl as the dipping item. Oh, it's delicious. Yeah.
You sound like you've got a good cob game.
Good cob. Yeah.
Cob life.
Yeah.
Good cob life.
Well, south of the Tweed, we just use actual bowls.
I'm going to make one on the show.
Do it. Bring it in.
Actually, I should make one.
It's a cob
Friday.
Off.
Yeah, and to bake the bread.
A cob off. I thought you would have been, like, all over the cob.
Why do you think I would have been all over the cob?
I just reckon
say
you would.
It. Spell it out. It's kind of my age.
It's a baby boomer thing, and I mean that with genuine love and affection.
I do. No, I've never had. I don't reckon I ever got into a cob loaf.
Yeah, right.
But you're going to make one.
Denise, did you ever poke cubes of cheese into a pineapple?
Yeah.
On toothpicks?
Yes, and gherkin. What do you call it? Little glass aid.
What about Jats and Cabana with with coon cubes?
Devils on horseback?
Yes, devils on horseback.
That's is that a prawn? No, that's a date wrapped in bacon?
Yes. Mm. I beg your pardon. it is indeed.
If you've ever owned a woman's weekly cookbook from the 70s, you would know what a cob loaf is. But I reckon we should definitely get on it. A cob off.
Why don't people, anyone watching, why don't you send in your pictures of your best cob loaf?
Yes.
And your best recipe.
Your best cob loaf. Send us in your cobs and we will show them.
And what we'll do, this is how our meetings basically work after the show. It's called, it's a production meeting.
Yes.
What we'll do, we'll pick our favourite viewer cob and we'll get one of the other hosts to make it and you can cob off against my cob, and we'll call it Get Your Gob on a Cob.
This is how genius. This is how genius ideas.
This is how the magic happens.
It's true. Forget pilot week. Stay right here on the studio.
This is the Dream Factory right here.
I like the song.
Brad is writing the song. And for more fun-filled events like the Cobb Festival, make sure you check out nightquarter.com.au.